Hi, welcome to my channel. So today I want to give you three tips on how to be a great artist. Tip number one, I'm going to get right to it. Create for yourself. Don't lose your unique voice. So many times in the art world or the writing world too, people think, well, what are they going to want to hear from me? What are they going to want to read? What are they going to want to buy? And when we start down that train of thought, our personal voice ends up getting lost. And nobody can do art like you. Nobody can write in your style. So it's very important that we create for ourselves. And then the right people will be attracted to your art. Because if I go out and I try to create for a particular audience, and let's say I have one big hit, well, and then I can't get that mojo back because I'm trying to be something I'm not. I can't recreate the magic, so to speak. You know what I mean? So then I end up turning out a bunch of stuff that I'm not having fun making, and I'm not enjoying the process at all. All because I'm trying to please some imaginary group of people. So that's tip number one, create for yourself. Okay, now on to tip number two. This was a big one for me. Tip number two is ignore negative feedback. That, along with that, you don't want to ignore constructive criticism. When I'm getting feedback on my art, I always consider the source. Does this person care about me? Is this person a competitor? What is the background of this person who's telling me this? And that will pretty much tell you whether or not to be listening to their feedback on your art. A lot of people, and this can be very surprising, but a lot of people within your friends and family will give you negative feedback because they want to keep the dynamic of the relationship the same. And you becoming successful is a threat. So lots of times I will keep what I'm doing under wraps to those closest to me because when I'm creating, that's the most fragile part of the process, and I don't need negativity flooding into my heart and my imagination when I'm trying to create something really special. So you can actually create in secret. It's one of the things I do to combat negative feedback. Now, when you're getting constructive criticism, when I'm getting constructive criticism, and you'll know it because the person loves you, the person actually cares about what you're trying to accomplish, that can be golden nugget advice for you. So, big difference between negative feedback and constructive criticism. But back to the negative feedback, you don't need it. It doesn't serve you. It doesn't help you. And those who want to keep you down aren't really for you to begin with. And that's a very difficult thing to go through because I've gone through it with some of the people closest to me in my life. I've had to eliminate relationships in my life over that very thing. So it's a tough one, and there are consequences that come along with it. But what's more important to you, being a successful, great artist or keeping the relationship? And that's something that you're going to have to pick. You know what I'm saying? So on to number three. And now tip number three. This is very important to me, and I have grown because of this tip so much in my being an artist. I have really advanced a very lot. I've come so far because of this. Tip number three is invest in classes. You know, everybody who's a professional has to invest time and money into their profession to be great. The beauty about being an artist is you never have to be after being the best because we all have such a different, unique voice. You just need to define what your idea of greatness is. What is my idea of greatness? Am I expressing from my heart? Am I making money at it? Those two things are kind of my definition of being a great artist. Am I speaking my voice? And are people interested? Those are what I look at as being a great artist. So I have invested, ever since YouTube came around, I grew more as an artist with the help of watching YouTube videos than I ever did without it. I probably grew more as an artist in the matter of like 4 years in comparison to the 20 years before that. So there are so many resources available. And when I say invest in classes, I used to faux finish. I used to do a lot of decorative painting in people's homes. And I took very expensive, very high-end classes to do it. And back then we didn't have YouTube, and I probably wouldn't have needed to invest the money. But I'm very glad I did for a couple of reasons. One, I made so many times over what I invested. And two, I got hands-on training that was just invaluable to what I was doing. Now I'm older and my neck and my shoulders have no desire to allow me to do that kind of work anymore. I've had to bring it down to a smaller scale, but I'm still happy and successful. So I have invested. You can invest money, which I have, and I still do. I will take classes online. I take classes from Craftsy. I take classes from Udemy. But the biggest investment that I'm talking about here is time. Sitting down with a YouTube video, getting all your supplies together, and actually painting along with the content creator that you're watching. This can be so invaluable to you. You are worth investing in. Your art is worth investing in. Cultivating your beautiful, great artistic voice is worth investing in. So a quick recap. Number one, create for yourself. Don't lose your unique voice. Number two, ignore negative feedback. And that's from the sources who don't have your best interests at heart, of course. And number three, invest in your artistic education. So real quick, I made these paintings. I was doing an art show a few years ago, and I really end up cranking out a lot of stuff because I procrastinate. I'm getting much better about that now. And so I cranked these out for the show, and I so loved how these came out that they're mine. I will not sell them. And this is absolutely speaks to my unique voice as an artist. These are all made with papers that I hand painted myself. This is corrugated cardboard. This is watercolor paper that I rested, and I have a video on how to rest paper. This beautiful crackle. This is a product called Deco. It's by Deco Media, and it's called Crackle Paste. And this piece really came out. The crackles look like a mini mosaic. I really love how these came out. And then I just really like to add things. So this is just a little C-clamp for a pipe, a plumbing pipe, and I got it at Home Depot and then alcohol inked it, and I put little brads in it. And you can see the brads in the back. And then I just did some wire bead work coming down like that. And then these ones, these are beads I got at Michael's. And I just simply sewed those into the canvas. This is all done with ink. These are 6 by 6 inch canvases with a 1.5 inch deep sides. And I base coated all these. I dripped ink and base coated them with ink, and then just went over with the crackle paste and the paint. And I had such a wonderful spiritual time making these because I am speaking with my own voice. So I am so glad you joined me for this video. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please click the subscribe button below and don't miss any more great videos in the future.